És most jöjjön a csendtörő Rose McGowan, akinek a MeToo mozgalom kezdetét köszönhetjük. Mexikóban vészeli át a koronavírust.
How do your days go now? Because I know that days fly. Literally they fly. I've been in my home for, what, 5 weeks? I haven't put my
Jesus. It's hard.
So what do? You go to the pyramids?
I don't go to the pyramids. I'm not going outside. We're not allowed on the streets. Mexico's pretty shut down. I go to the supermarket once a week. That's my big excitement. I talk to friends. I try to help a lot of people online that write to me about their pain, and that takes up a part of my day. Yesterday I was sobbing after seeing thousands of people in line for free food. This is a global epic disaster, and the finance part of it is going to kill more people than coronavirus.
You are an actor, a writer, a songwriter, an activist.
And I directed a movie.
And you directed a movie, that's true. So which is the real Rose McGowan, or which is your favorite Rose McGowan?
I think that's a great question. Acting was my least favorite Rose McGowan, because it wasn't me.
Why?
Because it hurt. Because I don't know if I would have been able to love acting had I not gotten raped so early on and terrorized so early on and betrayed by everybody around me so early and had people be so cruel to me through the years. I would have people come and sit next to me at a dinner party in Hollywood and be like, hey, heard you did Harvey Weinstein stories lately, just so they get a reaction from me. Because everybody knew for years, because it spread like wildfire through town when it happened. You're talking about somebody that stole my life and my body without my consent. It's not casual. And they would just terrorize me. And it was terrible. And I think I don't know the answers for acting, because I know it got stolen. I had fun doing it before that happened to me. After that, it became about survival.
You look like a teenager, by the way.
I'm 46. And you know what's amazing? And I have to tell you this. When I lived in Hollywood, it became so popular to do fillers and, you know, all that kind of stuff. I don't have anything now. And I look so much better, and I feel better.
You know why? Because you are an honest person.
Thank you, Aniko.
Introducing Planet Nine, the album. The first sentence you say, Hollywood is a strange place.
It's not normal to turn on the Oscars and see your rapist, you know, being thanked more than God.
Harvey Weinstein, who believed in us and made this movie.
Thank you, Harvey Weinstein.
Especially Harvey. I would like to thank Harvey Weinstein.
Harvey gave us just what we needed, another him.
Finally, I'd like to thank Harvey Weinstein. The Punisher, that's his nickname.
And God, Harvey Weinstein.
It's not normal to turn on the TV and see Gwyneth Paltrow giving him a humanitarian award when you know the truth. This is not okay. And it really messed with my brain for so very long. And I'll confess, I had some dark moments in the past, you know, like in the past 20 years. I had a couple dark nights where I was like, Rose, why didn't you just shut up? Why didn't you just not go after him from the beginning? Why didn't you sign an NDA? And I was like, I can't. It's not me. I would rather sacrifice everything, my house, my beautiful land, you know, my art collection, my furniture. I had strangers in my house picking through my clothes to buy them when I had to leave. Because I wasn't safe, and I needed the money to pay lawyers to fight him. This has cost me a lot. But most importantly, it almost cost me my sanity. But I feel like so much better now, and I'm not having active triggers. And to have him in jail, in prison, and thank God it happened before coronavirus.
What would be your bumper sticker if you could pick one?
Be better than you have to be. Because people can get by with being good enough, but I think people should aim for great.
You know what? You're good enough. Good enough. Thank you.
Thank you, Aniko. I hope we see each other again. It's been great talking to you.